in your life when you think, I just really can't do this anymore.
So the farm is at a crossroads, and we need to make some big changes. With my daughter, Molly.
It's a little bit smelly.
Son, Luke.
It's so cool.
And wife, Nicola.
The hole's definitely bigger than it was.
It's going to be a challenging few months.
Let's pull some force out.
Securing the farm's future.
Yes, a new fence!
And with the help of some friends...
Them donkeys are laughing at you, Gordon.
I think they will be.
Changing the way the farm runs.
Hey, now shall we go left or right?
You're beautiful, Joey, you are. Right, wait.
Are you going to put your hand warmer down and go and get a chicken?
What an adventure it's going to be.
Oh, no.
Welcome to our farm in the Dales.
It's been a huge task shoring up the future of our farm. And a big part of our plans have been changing our sheep, buying new flocks that will be the building blocks of the future. We're aiming to produce quality breeding stock, beautiful ewes and strong pedigree rams. We've bought sheep from right across the UK, from some of the highest parts of Britain.
Freedom!
From the Lake District, Herdwicks. From Snowdonia, Black Welsh Mountain sheep.
Gosh, I love their eyes.
And from the Scottish borders, Cheviot Hill sheep.
Chin chin to the Cheviots!
We've also worked hard to improve other areas of the farm.
The rain's against us, but we're not stopping.
All to make life easier for Mum and Dad.
I find it quite exciting, because, I mean, when your dad and I did it years ago and the place was derelict and we all stuck in and you were just a bit like Luke, really. We made it what it was. But now it's got to the point where it just needs...
refreshing again.
Refreshing, and it's brilliant.
For years, my dad has collected things to use when the time is right. He has a particular love of wood. So getting our next project off the ground may take a bit of persuading.
Family meeting. What are we going to do with this courtyard?
Well, we can leave the wood there for the fire.
Dad, look, that is not firewood. This, ready?
Perfect. Look at it.
This is not about upsetting anyone or annoying anyone. It's about making a better use of the space.
And we never got it undercover. Unfortunately, it wasn't well at the time.
So no, of course. Undercover.
You see, if we get all this cleared, we could drive in here with the buggy, turn round and then go out again.
And put some wood in the back, yeah. Yeah, I do.
You're happy that the wood goes?
Yes.
Yeah.
I can't believe we've just got the authority to move that wood.
No, I can't either.
When you come in here in a few days' time, Dad, it will look majestic.
I'm sketching out some plans for our next project. Now that we've built a new road around the farm, cleared away the ginkgang to make a usable area and fixed the barn roofs, we can get on with work in the courtyard. We'll clear away tons of wood, repairing the doors and windows, giving easy access to all of the buildings and creating a welcoming place to work.
First job, move the table.
Oh, I didn't expect that.
Don't trip over, Molly.
1, 2, 3.
We're going to take this out, actually.
Yeah, I think it's in the way here. Yeah. Because there's a whole pathway there as well to go from one building to the other.
This wood needs to go under there.
So, should we start clearing that out to make some space?
Yeah, you do that. I'll go and get the tractor.
I'll come with you.
But you've got a load of wood to shift.
Aw.
Sorry.
Right, these need to go in Grandad's shed.
In the bin.
There's some roofing bits here.
Where did the pegs go?
Oh, I can hear the tractor. Here he comes.
We've been walking around this wood for years and years. I'm amazed that my dad would let us shift it. But so much is changing and so much is happening around the place that he was like, you know what, let's just go for it. I mean, to be fair to me, Dad, there's the odd good bit in here.
The odd one. Shall I come up behind you just in case anything falls off?
I'll be all right.
I'm stacking the wood, so they're bringing it over.
And it's a fun
an easy job.
It's not that easy. Hold it, Mr. Snail.
We've salvaged the firewood worth keeping from the old log store and found some other bits from around the farm that we want to rescue and rehome.
It's getting there. It's just because it's like old varnish. It's like, yeah. It takes a lot of getting through.
It's very white. It reminds me of milk. Are we doing the handles?
You can do. Yeah.
Good, because I'm just starting.
I'm going to have to hide this from Nanny and Grandad so they can't see it.
They're going to come out tomorrow and be like, where's the milk churn gone?
It's incredible.
Doesn't feel so hemmed in, does it? I find pressure washing totally mesmerising. You just get lost in what you're doing.
The courtyard, the heart of every farm, is coming back to life. Before the sheep come into season, we select the males to run with the females for lambs due in the spring.
The first thing I need to do is separate the boys from the girls.
For our Hebridean sheep, I'm going to select just one male tub that will be the father of the lambs born next year.
Come on. So I'm just looking at the thickness of the horns at the moment. I can tell these ones here are all female, so I'll just open up, just push that there. Once you get them going, they start running like that, and then you can just work that gate at the end. There's a tub at the top here. See the difference in the horns? See the width there? An absolute beauty you are. You can go in. Thank goodness you've got a mate. Female, 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 male coming down. You go that side. Back to the females. There's a big male coming down. There he is, look at that. Whoa, go on, son. Almost like buffalo. So of the tups that we've had running with the females, we need to work out which one we're going to keep with them. Don't we? You're a pretty boy. Mind you, you're a mighty fine chap. He's got a bigger stature to him, wider horns. He's going to be the chosen one. There he is, look. He's good, he's strong. He's a nice boy. He's got a lovely head. Beautiful set of horns. He's a little bit bigger than the other boys. He's got a good stature about him. So I'm going to pop you through there. Excuse me. That's a good boy. Right, lads, you're going for a trip up the hill. See you later. So everything we've got on this side now, females, with one tub, which is the bloodline that we want to continue. Let's go to the woods. Come on, girls. No stragglers. Come on at the back. Don't get left behind. Good girls. Straight on. Don't turn right.
It's been 2 months since Bibby, one of our Cairn Terriers, had puppies. We've watched them grow up fast, and now they've reached the age for their first vet check. So Billy's back.
They're solid, aren't they? Look at the size of you. Hello, hello. They're almost as big as Mammy already.
She's done really well with them, hasn't she?
Is she all right herself?
She was quickly quite sick of them at about 5 weeks, I think. She decided enough was enough.
I'm sure motherhood is irritating eventually.
This is Dora.
Dora the Explorer.
I've got to listen to your little ticker first, make sure it's going.
Well, she has her heart, so we're alive.
That's all.
Always a plus. What weight are you?
About 2 kilos, would we guess?
2.08.
Yes!
Girl, good girl, good girl.
So that's Dora done.
So which is this one?
The family have named him Brandon.
You wonder if people pick names, don't you? We used to have a couple come in and they just got married. She wanted a cat and he wanted a dog. They were just married, so they got a cat. And they called the cat Rover. Okay, boy, we'll stop admiring you. And then, let's have a look at you.
That's Lola.
She was a showgirl, yeah? You're looking for obvious things like hernias.
Yeah.
Puppies often have umbilical hernias here, like a big belly button.
Yeah.
And then a lot of small dogs will have inguinal hernias down here.
Oh, really?
That's why I'm squeezing their tummies.
Ah.
It won't be long for you now. You'll be getting rid of them.
No, it won't. Just a few more days, and it's always sad. But on the other hand, it's quite happy because everybody's so much looking forward to them coming and so excited.
Right. Good talk boys. To Mummy.
Yeah.
Right. I'll see you later.
Great job. Thank you once again, Billy. It's nearly our last cuddly times, isn't it? Mm-hmm.
As part of clearing up around the farm, we wanted to do something with my dad's old 1946 American Dodge. It hadn't been started for over 20 years, so we had it taken to the local restoration garage. Unbelievably, with the help of some mechanical magicians, she's returned.
This is such a massive day. When the Dodge left the farm, I mean, I didn't know if it would return, and I'm gonna try and drive it up the track to meet me dad. He will not believe it. Come on, lads, come on. Yay, she's back. How are you doing? Let's get her up there.
I bet you're dying to drive her.
I am. How's she been, Keith? She's been all right?
Yeah, spot on.
Oh, man, brilliant. Well, we dug her out of the hole that she was in to be able to actually drive her again and take it up to the farm is going to be... Oh, it's going to be special. I cannot wait. I just can't wait to get behind the wheel. Here she comes. Welcome back! OK. Let's try and remember how you start this thing. So, clutch in. This barrel's up there, you turn that, and I think I'm on with my electrics. Push the button, fingers crossed. Yay! Oh, listen to that! Right. Oh, nice lovely column change on here. Into first. There we go. Oh, we're moving! Yay! Oh, sweetheart! The roof's literally falling off, but the engine is so sweet. Stick the arm out the window, living the dream. He is not going to believe it, I'm telling you.
My dad's old car that he thought he would never see running again is back.
Oh my gosh, she's gone so well. It's amazing. My dad is just not going to believe this.
There's been a lot of changes on the farm since the Dodge was last here. Not least the area from where it was parked for over 20 years.
Wow. Oh, it looks beautiful, doesn't it?
They've worked very hard, everybody has. I mean, you don't get it to look like that easily. You know, the fencing's nice and another donkey's not to walk across the road and all this sort of thing.
And it was nice when we drove around.
Yeah,
did like a big roundabout circle. Yeah.
The caravan and all the things that we wanted to do, an orchard, and never really got round to doing it, you know?
My dad has no idea about this next surprise.
But you walk up there, and when you get to the top... Oh, heck! Look at this!
Hey!
That is amazing! Can you believe it? Oh, look at that. Wow.
Now then, how are you doing?
Wow. I never expected this today. That is amazing.
Listen to that.
Isn't it lovely? It's a lovely engine, isn't it?
Hang on.
Well, it's all stuff this, Matt. You've got to turn the key to switch it off.
What do you reckon?
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Was that a bit of a surprise?
It was a hell of a surprise. Well, it was a surprise. I love it. But it brings back memories as this.
Let me back it up, right? And then you can take it for a drive down the track.
Put me out there.
Right, Dad, she's all yours.
Hey. Well, fancy.
Do you want the seat back a bit?
I think if a policeman stopped me and he'd been saying, you think this car's roadworthy? And I'd say, well, it wasn't, until you pulled the handle off.
Oh, I don't know.
They'll all be a bit stiff to begin with.
Yeah. Right, nice and gentle out on the left-hand side, and the clutch is quite high.
So to be able to get it to crawl, you know.
There she rolls, slowly, and off the accelerator, off the accelerator. Gently does it. Keep left.
Oh, my God.
There you go. Hey! Keep left, keep left.
Do you know, it always did have a tendency to go one way, this.
Onwards, driver. Like your chauffeur driving me around.
It feels lovely, doesn't it? It feels really good. I'm really pleased with it, son. It's got everything, this car, you know. It's got a nice radio, but the thing is, when you put it on, all you can hear is virulent. Right, I think Pat Memmings does this.
Yeah, feels like when you used to pick me up from school.
You haven't been a naughty boy again, have you? Am I going to the bottom?
We'll just stop at the gate.
I haven't got a sat nav. It's got Matt in the back.
Matt nav. And we'll stop there, Dad. Absolutely brilliant.
It's lovely. It's a lovely surprise. Thank you, son. Thank you very much. I must admit, I've really enjoyed it.
Pleasure.
One thing that we're very proud of on our organic farm are the ancient hay meadows, providing rich food for our animals right through the year.
In the depths of winter, what I love to do is break open a bale that we've baled in the summertime. And you sniff it like that, and it's like a summer day. And do you know what? You look in here, and it is full of so many wildflowers, herbs. It's like a salad out there. And what we want to do is make the most of these ancient hay meadows.
And so today, we're going to bring some workers onto the farm. Bees.
George, how are you doing?
Morning,
Matt. Precious cargo.
Yes, a few thousand bees.
A few thousand? Yeah. Oh, my word, fantastic. Let's find the best place for them.
Yeah, we'll find a suitable.
So, yeah, so this, George, is the area that I'm thinking about. This is basically kind of the hay section of the farm. In the springtime, in the summer, this place is just alive.
I can imagine, yeah.
This is the first choice, down the bottom here. Just dig your way through here. Opens right out to the valley across there, so I don't know whether or not bees like a good view or they like to see where they're going to be heading.
Not much to hear.
Basically, our woodlands start just through the mist there. It is very sheltered here. You'll have about 10 acres or so of wildflower meadows.
Potentially the back line there will be quite good for them, yeah, if it goes.
So will they utilise that?
Yes, they will, yeah. They get pollen from it.
How did you start off with bees, George?
We did. I job of working in a school. Got a hive at the school, fell in love with them instantly.
Literally,
instantly. Within weeks, I went and purchased my own hive, got my own bees. We're running about 180 at the moment.
180?
Uh-huh.
That could be the spot, you know. Just hearing what you've been saying there.
I think it's a great spot. I think it's got real good potential.
Yeah.
Only downside, I think it's going to be this road. On a wet day, difficult to get in and out when I need access to the bees.
Yeah, it is a bit of a trudge, this, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
The spot I'm taking to you now.
Uh-huh.
Dead easy to get to. I get so much sun here. There's a lot of shelter.
I was just noticing that, Matt, the access here is nice and firm. You've got the trees, which I'd say they'll be northeasterly, so that over there's going to protect us from that cold northeasterly wind coming off the coast.
We're not arable, we don't have crops here. What do you predict as kind of a food source?
I'm looking at your hedge lines, how nice and well developed your hedges are. I'm looking at what forage is in there. Blackthorn, which comes out into flower early. Hawthorn, which follows that. Hazel, willows are crucial in the spring because it's the first source of pollen for the bees to feed on. Yeah. And the one here will be our better option by far, yeah. And get that truck in and get them offloaded.
Perfect. I'm chuffed to pick this spot, actually, because it will be dead easy for my mum and dad to just go and have a nose. How do they cope with being moved?
They don't particularly like it. So once we put the bees here, they'll stop here.
So you've got the doorways facing this way, George?
Yeah, southeasterly. So when the sun comes up, it'll warm the front entrances up and that'll get the bees going early in the morning and it gives them a longer day to fly.
Clever stuff, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Oh, they're coming out here.
There's one or two escaping.
Yeah?
What they'll do, they'll fly around. They'll do a little figure of eight, like this little fella.
Yeah.
Just to see where his new home is. These are what we call winter bees now. The job is to maintain that hive, feed, look after the queen. We'll live for 5 to 6 months. So then your summer bees, it's a massive difference, 6 weeks.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. Because these hives are full of honey and pollen, so everything's in there that they need. They don't have to work as hard as the summer bees.
So what will be going on in there?
They'll be just trying to maintain a temperature between 32 to 34 degrees. They vibrate, and that could cause us the heat.
And how helpful for you is it that they're on organic land?
It's really important. I don't have to worry about pesticides on crops. although I can't call our honey organic because the bees will travel, they can go up to 5 miles away.
Oh, really?
And get the foams pulled out. Just gently get hold of it, slowly pull it out and pass it to me. If you need to, just step back.
Is it like pull it and run? Let the honey-making process begin.
Yeah, let's start from here.
Thank you, George.
You're more than welcome.
There you are, sweetie. Happy flying.
As the birds head to our woodlands to roost, for some, the night is young.
We're out doing a bit of bat detecting.
We've got a bat detector, which we're working out how to use.
So this time of night, when you come out, twilight, and you almost see them dancing around the rooftops at the courtyard.
Oh, there, that's it. There's one. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
They got a setting so, where you can tell what
so
that one is.
Basically, it said when you're first looking, set it at 45, because most bats operate at that sort of frequency. Then you can fine-tune it. And there's a list of all the different bats that are different frequencies.
Sounds like somebody splashing
so
the puddle.
So 45, out, which is what it's set as, is pipistrelle, whiskered, brants...
I think it's pipistrelle.
Okay. Point it that way, because they're flying.
There you go.
You see one?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah. Seriously, there it is.
Really?
Oh, wow.
Can you see them? Look.
Oh, my goodness.
They're going from those.
Yeah, yeah.
There.
Oh, my goodness. Is that actually a bat?
Yeah.
Yes, that 100%. Was actually a bat.
It went straight round and it's in that tree there.
Keep watching.
Oh.
Listen.
Shh, shh, shh.
Look, another one.
Yeah.
Wow, listen to that.
There you go.
There you go.
Wow. Sounds a bit like a woodpecker.
We love our bats, and this will be one of the last times that we see them before they hibernate for winter.
It's great, isn't it?
It's great. Really good.
Shall we leave them to it then? Night all.
Night, night, bats.
We've already chosen the Hebridean tup that will father the Hebridean lambs in the spring. Now, our attentions are turning to the Herdwicks, as we're about to start a breeding programme for them.
Let's go a tup choosing.
Romantic road trip.
We're heading for the Lake District to pay Joe Weir a visit, the farmer who helped us choose the females, as he's going to lend us a male tup.
Look at that landscape.
Even in the rain, it's beautiful.
Breathe in. It's tight round here.
It's tight, isn't it?
Herdwicks.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
Yay, Herdwick country.
Oh, that's so lovely. They just look, like, so ancient, don't they? Oh, gosh, I was excited about the ewes, and I'm, like, really excited now about the tup. Oh, I'm not having him if he's ugly, then.
I can't wait to see Joe again. What he doesn't know isn't worth knowing. We are here. What a place. Oh. Joe, nice to see you again. How's everything? All right. Yeah, apart from the weather. So these are the boys then?
Yeah, these are the tups.
This is the way to see them, isn't it? When they're out in the open, very much their kind of natural environment here.
Yeah, definitely.
How many's there, Joe?
About 35.
Wow.
Wow, they're beautiful. They're really handsome, aren't they? You know, the curly horns, will they all go like that? Or?
There's two types of tup. The ones without horns are called cowed. Now, if you took one of them, its sons could have horns.
Right.
It doesn't mean to say they're all going to be cowed, no horns. The ones with big horns are usually the big boys in the pack because, you know, they can give everyone a good punching, like.
They've
something to fight with.
Yeah. In your eyes, what makes the perfect tup?
A dark coat, a white head, white legs. They want two testicles, and the purse, as we call it, wants to be white, snow white. We're getting into finer detail.
I quite like the term purse. Just, you know, encasing the jewels, which are actually the most important part of the whole thing. It's interesting, isn't it?
You're picking all the best ones I don't want you to have.
God, they're really kind of like Viking-esque, aren't they?
Yeah, strong, that's for sure.
Yeah. Now then, lads, Let's have a closer look at you.
How do you pick from them? They all look gorgeous.
Yeah, who wants to come to Durham?
God, look at the size of him.
He's one of my favourites. He's a homebred sheep, but yeah. Look how strong his legs are. That's what we call bone. Unbelievable good bone. There's one here I thought you maybe would quite like, this one here.
Wowzers. There's a good boy.
Now, this is a shearling.
Right, he's a shearling.
Yeah.
So this one has only been sheared once. He's so young. But look at the size of him. I mean, he's incredibly well matured, isn't he? He's amazing, isn't he?
Mm. This is its armpit. That's got to be snow white. White hair, not wool. Got a pink skin as well, which is ideal. That's number one.
Yeah, I feel like we're on blind date. I thought it was like number one.
I like him. I like him a lot.
I didn't know if you wanted one with horns or one without, you see. There's one without horns. Now look at the bone in this.
Yes. Look at the front on
look
him.
At his clean under there.
Yeah. I mean, he's not dissimilar in stature, is he, to the other one?
No, this is one of the main things when trying to breed them is look where his legs are. Square, power.
I don't know, there's something about that first one. But, you know, if he's experienced and he knows what he's doing, is it better to take him?
That choice is yours.
Oh. What would you do if you were in my
it's
wellies?
It's a tough choice.
Oh, please, I'm not in your wellies.
That first one did something to my heart.
I think we both quite like him, don't we?
I think
your mum's going to love him.
Would love him. And I think, you know, you've been incredibly generous, honestly, helping us with the ewes as well.
You know, that's what we're all about, keeping the herd with sheep going.
Well, I'll tell you something, Joe, you're something else as a farmer.
I know, but when you care, that's what it makes you do, doesn't it? It drives you. You want to be over this way?
Right, let's get him loaded up. He's sizing me up.
Good luck, love. I'm not taking any bets on it.
Let the rustle begin.
Now walk them round to
okay.
you, and then you...
Go in for the
you
kill.
You go in for, well, not the kill.
Yeah, you know. In for the leap. Oh, nearly got him. Steady, boy. Steady, boy. Oh, boy, oh. Steady.
We're in the Lake District, picking up a male sheep for our Herdwick ewes. I've already chosen him.
Oh, boy, oh.
Now all I have to do is catch him to take him home.
Steady. Good boy. There's a good
boy.
Yeah. That's a good boy. Steady. Steady. Good boy. Good lad. There's a good boy. This is going to be the difficult part. Go on.
No, he'll hop in.
Yay! What a good boy. There he is. Man, boy.
It'll be nice Brilliant. When he sees his new girlfriend.
Oh, yeah.
Joe, thank you, mate.
No problem.
I'm massively out of breath, but totally grateful that they're all looking, thinking, oh, what was wrong with me?
Oh, don't. I feel really guilty now.
What a lad.
Just hope the girls like him. I mean, how can you not? How can you not stand in a field and go, yeah, he's nice.
Steady.
Is he going to go straight in with the girls?
No, I'm going to put him in the paddock at the front, get some little castrated males that won't challenge him, but will be good company. Welcome to the farm and your new home.
I wonder what your mum's going to say.
You wait till you see this boy.
Come on, boy.
Fantastic, isn't he?
Oh, look at him. God, he's an amazing animal, isn't he? Beautiful. Oh, he's definitely got it about him, hasn't he?
Yeah.
He's just checking out his horizons at the moment.
Looking around everywhere, he looks like, you imagine, the grand tuck to look, doesn't he? He's got that look about him.
Bats are an important part of the ecosystem, and seeing them proves that we have healthy biodiversity on the farm. As they're a protected species, me and my dad are going to help them hunker down for the winter.
We're going to put some bat boxes together, aren't we, Dad, that we got? We got these online. If you look at the backboard here, that's like a little ladder that they're going to crawl up, and then we'll build the bat box around here, and there'll be a couple of little chambers. They're dead simple. You've put that one together already, haven't you?
I mean, all you do is screw them together.
Now is the kind of perfect time to be doing this, because they're just about to go into hibernation, so they're going to be looking for a little home. So
we better get a move on then.
Yeah, exactly.
Make sure the slope goes to the front like that, and that one there, make sure the slope goes to the front like that, and then the front.
Yeah.
Like that. Yeah, that's it really.
I think it's got a box on the end. My dad'll have made it at some point. It's such a lovely thing to be given wildlife a home, and to be
it
honest,
it is, isn't it?
Yeah. It doesn't really matter where you live, you can do it, because you can give insects a home if you want. Everything's got to live somewhere.
Including the squirrels, but not here.
Don't start on the squirrels. It's something that I've grown up with, and really, I don't know any different. Come hibernation time, just beforehand, you do your best to give those that have decided to come and check out where you live a place to stay. Quite cool having bats around, though, isn't it?
Yeah, you can hear them talking to each other. Yeah. Click, 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 click.
It's almost there. That's where the bat would climb up into, up that ladder. And then if I pop that in there, so they've got like a two-bedroom apartment. And believe it or not, you'll get like 10 to 20, wouldn't you, Dad?
Yeah.
That'll crawl up into there. It's unbelievable. Nice little chamfered roof on there, just to protect them from the elements. One little screw in the top and we're done, Dad. All ready to put up and move in. Shall we leave those for the kids to put on?
Yeah.
Nicola got them? You know what she's like.
Batty, yeah.
The bats aren't the only ones busy this evening. I'm out feeding the sheep, because before we can settle down for the night, the animals always take priority, especially when the grass is in short supply.
About 10 of the small square bales into one of these big round ones, so it's really efficient way actually if you've got the kit to be able to move them. Got all that lovely hay in there, look. You just munch it down. Any more on? And these ring feeders here, they just stop them clambering all over the bale. This one around this side. They've got plenty of room to get around the back here, so that's good. Pop the pins back in. This is me 100% in my element. You can't beat this. Dropping bales in, you've got the lights on. It's just spectacular. Nobody around and freezing coldness. This is me happy. Up to my ankles in mud, feeding the sheep. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Come on, girls.
This protective line of pine trees were planted to shelter the farm from the gales that blow down the valley. They're the perfect spot for our new bat boxes.
Very nice.
After a few finishing touches.
Oh, that looks good there.
I think they look lovely. Yeah.
Now all we need to decide is which tree to put them on.
We need to find somewhere where we can get the boxes sort of high enough off the ground that's got some sunlight for part of the day at least.
That one there.
Can you see a patch of light on that one and this one here?
Yeah, I like that one over there.
Oh, yeah, that's like a spotlight.
Thank you.
Which one for this tree?
Should we do that one first?
So direction-wise, I think it's all right as long as it's open. Does that look straight?
There, yeah, that looks about right.
Oh, look at the patch of sunlight on it.
Ah.
Done.
Coming down. Very good.
Great.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah, that looks great, doesn't it?
Yeah, well done, everyone. Oh, they look lovely, and you see the little bats on them all.
Whole new house is this.
We've been working hard, transforming the courtyard from an old storage area for my dad's wood to a more usable space that's an enjoyable place to work. We've cleared away years of debris, and the new look courtyard is taking shape.
Oh, it's very light. Supposed to be stone.
It'll act like a sun reflector. You can come in here and like get a massive tan. Big shift shutters to try and hold the weather out.
Right, here we go. No going back now. Definitely need a few coats. We gave Mike and Janice some options for colours. So they went with a stone colour so it might match the other wall. It's quite a nice light, bright choice. I'll quality control it in a bit.
Oh, that's not good.
Hey, girls, don't be alarmed. Shifting the plough. Find it a new home in the courtyard. Basically, that front wheel there sits in the last furrow or the last row that you've ploughed. These blades at the back here cut the soil and turn it over. So we're going to use it as a bit of an ornament.
Plough on, team.
You got a sinking feeling?
Dad, I'm building a mini planter wheelbarrow.
How we doing, Moles?
Okay.
So we're just putting in the final touches now, collecting some bits and bobs around the farm that we've already got, and that make it just look a little bit more, I don't know, a bit prettier and a bit softer. And then we can get Mike and Janice in to see what we've done and celebrate finishing it.
Here? I think we should put it up here.
Should we put it to an angle a little bit so you can see the site? That's good.
Like that?
Yeah, I like that.
This is a little stone cantero that we've got. I think it'd be quite nice as a doorstop when it's really windy.
Can't believe it. Everyone's worked really hard. Well done, kids.
What do you think?
No wood.
No wood, yeah.
No wood. Big day for the new Herdwick flock. So the top that we've picked up from the Lake District has been resting in this top paddock here. And we've brought up the ewes into this top section of the donkey paddock.
She's looking all alluring by the tree, look.
Normally, with sheep, you put your tups in on bonfire night, so there's plenty of fireworks, and that means that you get April the first lambs. But Herdwicks are a little bit later.
Here she comes.
All right. Stop there. Got some feed?
I have.
This should be quite easy, he says, with like everything crossed. Shall I open his gate first?
You open it up and walk along with it.
You call it.
You shake it, yeah. Yes, come on then. Come on, big boy.
Rampant, look at him.
Come on. Oh, we've got the other two. Shake it up there, Matthew. Come on. There's a big boy.
We're in business.
Come on.
He doesn't realise what's happening.
No,
and he's just so focused on his breakfast at the moment that... So Nicola's going to go around the back and shut the gate behind him. Here we go. He's seen him. Come on. Here he goes. Come on.
There now.
He's a good boy.
I like the way you just sort of look back as if to say... See you, chaps. Got other business to attend to.
Wow, this is it. Put on the Barry White music.
Ooh, hello, girls. New kid on the block. Ooh, hi.
They all look good together. Oh, look at him with his head up.
He says, who smells nice today? There he goes.
Here he goes.
Look.
Here he goes. This is his first season. Whoop, there you are.
They didn't even have time for a Coke and a bag of crisps.
And actually, this is the first time that they've been top two, because they're three-year-olds.
Oh, look, there's a few of them like shaking their tails.
Straight in there. Yep, she's standing there. It's all there
happening.
You are.
He's at it again. Goodness me. Wow.
Careful who you share that with.
Yeah.
Get the diary out. We'll work out the dates. We'll know in about 5 months' time.
What you'll often see as you drive around is coloured marks on the back end of sheep. And what that is you just put a load of paint on the tub, on their tummies, so that he rubs the paint off from his belly onto her back end. You'll change the colour as the weeks go on. So you know when they're due, you see. It's a clever system.
It's a good morning's work.
Yeah. Well, he's having a good morning's work. Stop watching him, it's getting weird. Give him a bit of privacy.
They don't need an audience.
No, right now, absolutely.
So. He's obviously not that bothered.
It's a day of mixed emotions as the puppies are leaving the farm.
Luke, would you like to do the scanning?
Yeah.
Because Annie microchipped them about a week ago to check that that is still in.
The chip should be on the back of the neck there, so if you run it across.
Give me the last three numbers.
243.
243.
You paws are so wet.
Ah. I'll really miss the company. But I'm quite looking forward to, in the morning, not having to get up at 5:30 to the smell of puppy poo.
From Glasgow to Liverpool, they're off to their forever homes.
Nice to meet you, Jackie. I'm going to get my mask on and then I'll come across.
I'm nervous, are you?
I am.
Can't wait to see you.
Oh! Hello. He's nearly got one ear up this morning.
Hello, Brandon.
There's your new mummy and daddy. I'll pass him that way. We took him into your side. That's it, you've got him.
Hello, beautiful.
You're going back to puppy.
I know. Oh, look
at you. There's nothing like the smell of puppies, is there?
Oh, he's gorgeous, look.
Hello.
We've waited for 5 years to get a cairn because we lost our last one. And now we've got a lovely little Brandon. I love the Killers, and I just wanted to call my dog after Brandon Flowers, the lead singer.
Safe journey home, good luck. Excellent, job well done. It'll be nice to have the living room back to normal, and then I'll be ready to start again next year.
And it's new starts all round, as my vision for the farm is beginning to take hold.
To be standing where I am right now and just looking out onto all of this. You know, we've got the Hebrideans here, the Hampshires are next door. We've got this wonderful flock of Cheviots and the Black Welsh Mountains as well, with the Herdwicks up on the hill. You know, I'm so, so grateful. The people that we've met, the expertise that we're benefiting from. I can't actually believe we've achieved what we've achieved. You know, the farm itself is running smoother. It's easier for my mum and dad to look after. As a family, we love it. And I'm just happy that we've managed to create something together. It feels like it used to feel. A magical place.
The courtyard is finished. The last time that mum and dad were in here, it was a very different place.
Oh, my word!
Isn't that lovely?
Absolutely incredible.
Hey, this is amazing, isn't it?
I'm loving the fairy lights. Well, this is epic.
Look, Dad, no wood.
Oh, no wood.
Well, it's
well, I don't
amazing.
Know where you're going this evening, dear, but I'll be staying here.
Isn't it beautiful, isn't it?
This reminds me of your wedding. Yeah, it hasn't looked as nice since then, until now. I absolutely love that.
It's amazing, isn't it?
We put it in the front room.
Well, would you like a glass of mulled wine to celebrate finishing the courtyard?
Is this not better than what was here before?
I've got to have
you.
Yes! It looks like some sort of steaming... Look at that, it looks like a steaming potion.
It does, doesn't it? Molly and I have made some bat cakes.
Wow! Look at that.
Kids, do you
look like?
Isn't
cute?
It is look like.
Well, I made the topping of it. Mm. Like, we stuck giant chocolate buttons on the sides and stuck some eyeballs on them.
We also made a bit of bat loaf.
Look at that, look, it's got bats in the middle.
Wow.
Shall I tell you what has been amazing, to be honest with you? Just driving in here.
Yeah.
Imagine this on a summer's evening.
So you've got a usable space, but a nice space.
Well, it's a fantastic achievement, isn't it, all of this, when you think how far we've come. When I had my accident and broke my leg and all of that, and it was all...
How are we going to cope?
Well, and it was really scary, because you begin to think, well, what is actually going to happen? And how are we going to cope? And it brings everything home. And for the first time, I felt vulnerable about the place, and I never have ever before. Now, with all the changes that are taking place, it's fantastic because you
things are so much easier to do, aren't they?
Yeah, and I'm beginning to see what I can do, the enjoyment, and hopefully we can maybe all together go and do some showing and do some nice things with some fabulous sheep that we can get. And luckily, we've been so lucky to get some fantastic stock.
Yeah.
So we're secure in the future, not only just for you, but hopefully for the next generation as well. We're in a lovely place, aren't we? And the effort that everyone's put in. So thank you, Molly. Thank you, Luke. Thank you, Nicola. Thank you, Matthew.
Thank you all. Very good.
Here we go then. Peace to the next chapter.
Cheers.
Cheers.
We're writing it pretty quickly, that's for sure. Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, what a lovely night it's been. It took a bit of convincing to start with to do the work in here, but I'm so glad that we did. You know, a courtyard is the heart of any farm, and it really does feel to me like it's beaten again. I'm really proud of what we've all done here.
Going for the win against America's Olympic Committee tomorrow night, The Good Fight is new here at 9. Keeping it Lux over on Channel 4 tonight, who are all about the pre-loved and preposterously expensive labels. Second hand for 50 grand is new next. Numbers that might actually add up next here on More 4 with 8 out of 10 cats doing countdown. Might actually add up next here on More 4 with 8 out of 10 cats doing countdown.